gentlemen, welcome to tonight's main event.
Now,
here he is, Tom Leykis.
It's the final edition of the Tom Leykis Show. Our telephone number here, 888-520-9710. The final hour. The final listener party taking place tonight at Molly Malone's, 6th Street and Fairfax. Right there on the west side of Fairfax Avenue, Molly Malone's. You'll know it's Molly Malone's because it's packed to the gills and you'll see the crowd. It's blasting on the speakers at Molly Malone's, and I guess you'll get to hang out and listen to the final moments with other Tom Leykis listeners. So that is right now Molly Malone's on Fairfax, just north of 6th Street. It's Flash Friday. You asked for it. Our final show is a Flash Friday, so turn your headlights on to show that you have been a loyal listener to the Tom Leykis Show. Headlights on, everybody. And ladies, if you see somebody with the headlights on, jump right in and show them why they are loyal listeners. Give them something as a reward for all that hard work of tuning in every Friday for so many years. Our telephone number here is 888-520-9710. We only have one more hour today, and then that's it. The station's going to change format coming up in 1 hour. And then we're free. Well, free FM? No, we're just free, period. Anyway, let's go to your telephone calls here. Let's say hello to Greg in the City of Commerce on the Tom Leykis Show, final edition. Hello.
Hello, Daddy-O.
Hello, Greg.
Man, it breaks my heart to see you go, Tom, but I just wanted to say one thing to all the fellas out there, that we got to keep your legacy living on, and we need to keep treating these bitches like the bitches that they are. A couple things I wanted to ask you before you go off the air. One of them was you know, I was always curious as to if, do you, when you bang women, do you bang them with, your, with those black shades on?
Sometimes.
And also,
no, I'm not going to let you get to the other part of the Craig call, but thank you. Pauline.
Hello, Tom.
Hi.
First time. I've been listening for 5 years. I'm now 17. And
so in a sense, I've helped raise you.
I'm sorry?
In a sense, I've helped raise you.
Yeah, pretty much. My mom's actually a single parent, and she heard of you, and she immediately made me turn to you and make me listen, and because she's made so many mistakes, but even though I turn out well, I take your lessons more to heart, and I'm definitely not going to be in that situation where she was. And oh my gosh, I just, now that I'm 17 and you're leaving, I don't know what I'm going to do.
I don't know. How do you make it to your 18th birthday now?
How long?
No, how do you make it until your 18th birthday without me here?
Oh, I know. That's why I'm calling. I just wanted to know if you have some last-minute advice.
Just don't get knocked up, dear. Please.
Oh, definitely not.
Please don't. No matter how many times you watch Entertainment Tonight or you read Us Weekly about baby bumps and all this stuff, it's a very bad idea. You can't afford a nanny the way, you know, Lindsay Lohan could or Christina Aguilera. You can't afford that.
No, definitely not.
You know, so stop paying attention to Jamie Lynn Spears and just make sure you don't get knocked up like she did.
Oh, I know. Oh, God, thank you so much for all these years, and I'll just be keeping out for you.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Good luck to you, Pauline. Now, how could this happen? 2 days in a row, we have somebody named Dinette. This is not the same Dinette as yesterday. Dinette?
This is actually Dinette.
Oh, Dinette.
Yes.
Is that just like Dinette, only it's Dinette?
Only it's got a duh. Mm-hmm.
Duh.
Yeah, like Dinette. Yep. I just wanted to call you, first of all, and say I've been a fan for a long time of not just you, but the whole radio station. And I was listening to the final episode of the Triplets, and I just wanted to set the record straight with you.
I'm waiting.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was looking at the online and it came off. But anyway,
stop looking online and start talking. Turn those lights off. So, we have those on for TV.
No, it's cool. I wanted to just let you know that Frank did go off. I think he was a little drunk and very upset, which I'm sure that you guys all are. But at the end, he just said he wanted to set the record straight, and he said that they're all, you guys are all like a big, happy family.
No, I heard what he said, but he did not take back what he said.
He did.
No, he didn't. He said, we argue like a happy... Brothers Fight is not taking it back.
Yes, I agree. But
it's taking it back means saying what I said was a big, fat lie. That's taking it back. A big, fat lie that you have no way of verifying.
Yeah, well,
he did not take it back,
that, and he's just upset and wants to. Take
I don't get you.
Somebody.
By the way, you know what?
I know
he's a professional. I'm a professional.
I know.
Now I don't come on the air here and do unprofessional things like give you Frank's real name or tell you things about his personal life that he doesn't tell on the air. I don't do unprofessional things.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. There's a lot of things about Frank Kramer you don't know. I could tell them all right now.
I don't want to know.
No, right.
Imagine.
I mean, now, I've kept Frank's secrets all these years. I've never said a word about what I know about him personally. And I'm not going to do that on this final show.
Okay.
But, so I think I was professional.
You were.
So I think to come on the air and to say something that is blatantly false, I mean, it's actionable. I could call my attorney, and the fact that he's drunk is not a defense. I could call my attorney, and I could own him. Okay, but I'm not going to do that.
I'd hate for you to do that.
But what he said was a lie. It was not just a joke, or it's not just kidding around. It's not just brothers disagreeing. It was a lie.
Okay.
And if he can prove that what he said was true, I'm ready to hear it.
Well, I wish you the best. I just wanted you to, I wanted to make sure that you heard that part. I apologize. It's not what you wanted to hear, but thank you for all these years. I will be a follower with you, and you have a good, safe journey, okay?
All right, Dinette. Say hello to the living room chair for me. Chad in Aspen, Colorado. You're on the Tom Leykis show. Hello.
Hello, Dad.
Hi, son. How are you?
Thank you so much for everything you did, man. You are the man. You did it up so well, and you know, you turned my life around. I about 5 years ago moved out to California. Moved out there. I wasn't listening to you quite yet. It took a couple years for me to start listening to you, and I did. I started listening to you. I was in a relationship that sucked. I was losing all my money. I wasn't making good money. Didn't really think too highly of myself. And then one day, man, you came on the radio and you said, you know, guys, you need to think better of yourself. You're better than that. You could do better than that. And I felt like I could. And I moved back here, Tom, and I own my own property now. I own my own property. I just bought a new car, and I'm making damn good money. And it's because of what you said to me that one day. And I want to thank you so much for that, Tom. You changed my life, and you made me a better person.
I am very proud of you, and I thank you very much for that call. Fabian, you're on the Tom Leykis show. Hello.
Hey, Father. How you doing,
I'm doing okay.
Father, I just wanted to let you know I'm at work. I have my lights turned on. I'm wearing my Leykis 101 shirt, thinking of you. Just want to give you many thanks for all these years. You made me hold on, and as a matter of fact, this year I'll be graduating college, and I will personally like you to invite you to my graduation if you have some time. And honestly, right now I'm about to cry, but man, I love you, and whatever you do, just keep it strong and keep it going. Can you blow me up?
Of course I can, Fabian. Here you are. Triple 8 520 9710. I'm going to say it the wrong way every time. It's going to be like the subway jingle. I'm going to say the wrong number and then the right number every time. This is Scott on the final edition of the Tom Leykis show. Hello.
This is not Scott, actually.
Okay. Oh, I see. Scott is on another line here. All right. Well, then I'll say hello to Roy.
Hello, Tom.
Hello. Roy is in Chicago, by the way. Have you called in before? I believe you have.
I have. This is my third time caller.
Look at
you. Third time caller.
Long time listener. Third time caller.
Tom, I've been listening to you since 2006, since that crazy woman called up on the air and confessed murder. And ever since, I could not put your show down. I'm a loyal listener. I'm going to miss you, but like you said, it's a business decision. You know, all the callers are, oh, you got to stay. Well, we'd love you to stay, but, you know, like I say, it's a business decision. Wish you the best with whatever you do, and I think that's about it, Tom. I think it's only proper to be taking out old school style, so why don't you go ahead and blow me up, Tom?
I'm proud to do it, Roy. Here you go. Tom is usually our telephone number. Right now it's 888-520-9710. Come on over to the station, big boy. Come on over. I do it from Paramount. Come on over here. Don't worry about it. Don't worry, it's your last show and it's your legacy and every button you press is going to do the wrong. Come on over. It's fine. All right, let's do stage direction now. Are we ready to play the bump here? All right, Gary's going to press the button, and this is going to indicate a commercial break that's coming up now on the final edition of the Tom Leykis Show.
Tom Leykis, 1-800-5800-TOM, 1-800-5800-866, the Tom Leykis Show.
Final edition. And we're here at 888-520-9710. I got it on the first try. I think right about 4:55 I'm going to get that right. Thank you so much for tuning in. I want to bring somebody on here who does not want to go on the air, but I'm going to bring him on anyway, just for a minute. Because I've mentioned his name on the air hundreds of times. And he's never been here to actually properly respond. So I've been in this business, you know, since I was 14 years old, longer than I care to remember. And about 21 years ago, I met this gentleman who worked down the hall from me, and I have named him on the air repeatedly, much to the chagrin of Jack Silver, the program director of this station. I have mentioned him on the air as the finest, the best, the most top-notch, number one, best possible program director in the entire world. Is your title program director today?
I've gone backwards in my career. That's all I have now.
Okay. He is the program director of K-Earth 101, one of the top-rated radio stations in Los Angeles, one of the most profitable radio stations in the world. And I have said that although Johnny K does not do a talk radio format, I have said that, and I believe me, this is me talking, that I trust his judgment so much. If he told me to do something on the air or not do it, I would bow at his altar and simply comply.
Oh, man. Thank you so much for that. And when you said that, a staff member here was listening, ran down the hall, and brought me a recording of your comment. Do you remember what I texted you?
I do. And you know what's interesting about that is that I know that as a program director, you have to tell people what to do. That's your job. You're going to tell them what to do. It's got to be hard for them to take that on faith that somebody knows more than they do, or maybe somebody had more experience. After all, the program director frequently assembles all the talent, puts them in there, puts them in the booth. But for my money, there is not anybody who knows better. Not anybody who knows better what to put on the air. K-Earth 101. Again, the most consistently programmed radio station. And Johnny K, for people who don't know, for how many years was it Coast?
Right, about 17, 18 years. Yeah.
Coast. Yeah, I mean, Coast was just a monster forever.
I would like to point out, though, that day when you said, I told you what to do, I texted Tom, and I said, just keep doing what you're doing because it's going to win.
Yeah, he did. And I'm trying, I took that as such a compliment from you because, honestly, if you sent me a text message and told me that I was just doing anything, even a slight tweak, I would more than happily make that adjustment because a greater technician of the radio business you will not find. And, we have never gotten to work together because we kind of do different things in the radio business, but Johnny and I have been friends for a long time, and he's just the best, and I want to say that to him face-to-face on the air.
Thank you very much. And given the opportunity now, I will give you this one little bit of advice.
Yes.
Part your hair on the other side.
Thank you so much, Johnny.
Thank you.
Johnny K, K-Earth 101. Since I won't be here, that's an alternate place you can go. Go listen to my friend Shotgun Tom Kelly over there. Absolutely. Party doesn't start till Shotgun gets there. Shotgun's been to my home just as Johnny has many times. And he's just the best, too. Tell you what. 1-800, nope, 888-520-9710. That's our telephone number, the final edition of the Tom Likas Show. Will we make you proud? Will we take you out at the end of the show and make you feel good? Well, I'm hoping there won't be a dry eye in the house. That's my hope. But in the meantime, it's Flash Friday. Headlights are on. All the Tom Likas listeners, one last time turning the headlights on. The big after party, the final listener party, if you will, is at Molly Malone's, 6th Street and Fairfax in Los Angeles. It has already begun, and you can go over to Molly Malone's and listen to the last moment of our show together with the other listeners. And I believe you can go over and talk to Frank Kramer about how I was so stingy because I wouldn't take a pay cut so he could stay employed. Maybe I could bring a check over to Frank. Just bring him some cash. Dee Dee, on the Tom Likas Show, I can never resist asking the following question. Dee Dee, your last name is not Cup, is it?
It's close. Very close.
Darling, you got to get off the speakerphone. It sounds dreadful. Unless you're driving.
No, I was in an elevator.
Oh. Okay. You're on the Tom Likas Show, final edition.
Tom, gosh, I feel stimulated.
Is that so?
Yes, I'm actually feeling, I don't know if I can say this on the air, wet.
Well, it's probably because you're sweating.
Yes, and I'm at work, so I had to kind of sneak around because I wanted to talk to you so bad. This guy Frank is such a joke, and as far as he's been on the air, it is amazing to me in itself. He... and a couple of his partners, I'm sorry, I just believe that they're all a joke. And compared to you, they're, all I see is jealousy. You've got a future and they don't. And misery loves company.
Well, thank you for all that, Dee Dee. All I'm going to say is that, you know, my belief... regardless of what anybody says, is to be professional. Professional towards my employer, professional towards the radio business.
Yes.
Try to be professional towards the people I work with.
Right.
To come on the air on the last day and start accusing anyone of anything, I think is unprofessional. And, right. And if you had a problem with that, by the way, how about you meet me in the hallway here, we discuss it. Or in the parking lot behind the building, discussing this man.
Exactly. Finally, the truth comes out at the end, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, he had plenty of time to, you know, give me an old ringy-dingy here and tell me he had a problem with me. Why didn't I hear from him?
That's right. We can get it on.
You know, I mean, if he needed money, why didn't he just ask?
He still might, Tom. Okay?
Well, as I said, my offer for him to till my fields up in San Ynez, I'm holding firm on that. It's available. And I've got my studio there if he needs to record his podcast at the end of a tough day working the soil.
Yes.
I'm more than happy to let him come in and use my studio.
You know what, Tom? I've told my fiancé to listen to you all the time. I tell him to go out with his boys. And I totally love you, Tom. Orange County. I tell everybody I know around me, listen to Tom, listen to Tom. And this is really heartbreaking. I just want you to know that I love you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you, Dee Dee. I appreciate the call. Let's go to Scott here on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Scott.
Hey, it was great working with you at the Paramount lot. I'm glad I can finally say it on this last day. Just want to thank you, Gary, and Dino for being awesome colleagues.
By the way,
friends.
Scott, knowing that the radio station is playing over there at Molly Malone's and knowing that you've been to my 20-acre spread, tell Frank Kramer what he's missing.
Oh, if he wants to take a job over there, he can come plant tomatoes in some of the best acreage in the world. I mean, it's the nicest place I've ever seen. And it'd be well
How was that view of sunset that day? Did you enjoy that?
It's awesome. I have it on my computer desktop. I look at it every day.
Love that.
Love it. But I just want to thank you guys. Even before I knew you guys on the Paramount lot, I was a fan for 5 years listening to you going back and forth. But, man, you had a great show. It was an awesome run, and I'm glad you guys lasted as long as you did. And I know that if it wasn't for the station's economic, you know, trouble, you'd be still on the air. So with that, I'd like to say thank you once again. And if it's all right with you, I'd like to pass the phone to Aaron from the deli.
Absolutely. From the Water Tower Cafe. Absolutely.
There
here
you
he
go.
Goes.
1 second. Tom, how are you?
All right, Aaron. How are you?
I'm fantastic, Tom. It is a bit of a sad day across the lot, I got to tell you, my friend.
I'm sorry to hear that. of course, we came over to the radio station today.
Uh-huh.
So we were not able to do the last show from the Paramount lot, but we're going to miss you guys.
Yeah, I just want to tell you, man, it has been a pleasure having you on the lot the last couple of years, and you and Dino and Gary and Art and Javi, the whole crew over there. Love seeing you at the cafe. Going to miss your visits, buddy.
Well, I'll drop in if you can get me on the gate list there. I'll come over.
Tom, you have a VIP access. Anytime you want to come to the studio, you let me know. You and all your friends can drop by. And, hey, thanks again for having me out at the ranch for Super Bowl Sunday Spectacular.
Frank asked me to have you tell him how the ranch is. How is it?
The ranch is absolutely beautiful, man. I mean, it is amazing. I had the time of my life out there. Beautiful, absolutely.
Well, thank you for that. So he'll enjoy working the fields up there. Is that what you're saying?
Absolutely. Are you kidding? It would be a pleasure. I would work up there if you want me to. Not a problem, buddy. Are you kidding? With that kind of scenery, Tom?
Sounds,
all right, man.
Sounds good to me. Aaron and Scott, thank you so much for calling in. We're going to miss you guys over at the Paramount lot. We really are. 888-520-9710, the final edition of the Tom Likas Show, the final Flash Friday. The final Flash Friday, so headlights on, everybody. And ladies, show us your knockers. If you've got headlights on there, guys, hopefully you will get flashed. And don't forget the big after party, the final listener party, if you will, at Molly Malone's on Fairfax, just north of 6th Street here in Los Angeles. And, yes, we will drop by, absolutely. And hopefully we'll see you there as well.
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. The Tom Likas Show.
With the tradition of Bette Midler and Johnny Carson, here's a little ditty for you. Hope you like it.
Farewell, Mr. Likas. Now it's time to hit the road. So here's a swing and send-off for your final episode. So grab a Sharpie, sign a rack, and don't ask why. No, like it's 101, it's hard to be a guy. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you have the time of your life. God knows I did. Kobe beef martinis, the times. A cocktails in the studio was always a great hang. Think of all those photographs of hot chicks that you banged. Tattoos on strippers' backs and all those milfs gone wild. You managed to do them all without having a child. It's something unpredictable. Such a crazy scene. I dread the day my daughter turns 18. Yeah, I hate to say it, but she's just about trophy wife age. So long, fellas. Thanks for never ratting me out.
Our good friend from Seattle and the Jet City Swingers, and of course we never ratted him out. He's a member of the Brotherhood, for God's sake. And we did have a lot of great times together. HB even came to Los Angeles and did at least one of our Playboy Mansion parties, matter of fact. That was fun. And that was pretty wild. It was kind of a mixing of cultures, the Seattle culture and the Playboy Mansion.
He wasn't lying about those Kobe beef martinis, by the way. He actually brought them down to the studio one day and made martinis with pieces of Kobe beef.
Instead of olives.
Disgusting.
And the Kobe beef was starting to disintegrate in the glass. If you ever wonder what would happen if you took 100-proof vodka and mixed it with Kobe beef, we found out...
It was a manly drink, though.
It was kind of like Mentos and Diet Coke. Practically exploded out of the glass. Yes, one of the many things we did over the years. It's the final edition of the Tom Likas Show, coming to you from the studios of 97.1 FM Talk. In half an hour, the station will be no more. The format will change, and we will go off into radio history. That's right. And in the meantime, we're talking to you on the telephone at 888-520-9710. Coming up, we'll take, in a few minutes, take one last commercial break, and then we're going to go straight through to the top of the hour. So this will be our last commercial break coming up in just a few minutes here. So let's go to your calls here at, well, let's say hi to Don in Duarte. Don, you're on the final Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, hey, Tom, this is John, actually.
Oh, John. Well, it said Don on the screen.
I'm sorry. That's my
error. And our screener is an Italian, and these things happen.
You know what, Tom? You're the man. You got a great crew. The Frosty, Heidi, and Frank show, particularly Frank, was nothing but auditory wallpaper. That's just my opinion. But it was torture to tune in to the end of their show while I was waiting for yours to get on the radio for years. So thank you for all the years. I think there's no time for goodbyes. I just need to know where you're going to be next, man.
Well, keep an eye on our MySpace. It's myspace.com/TomLikas. TomLeyKis. Or blowmeuptom.com. You'll find us in either one of those places.
Tom, I just signed up to be your friend on myspace.com. You're my hero. I wish I tuned in sooner, but, you know, I'm really grateful for the fact that you're there. Dude, you know, as everyone else knows, you made that station. I'm a communications major. I liked Howard Stern. I loved you, man. You are my hero.
Thank you so much for that. Jim in West Hollywood, you're on the final Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Father.
Hello, son.
How are you?
Do you care?
We do.
I'm doing great.
This is your gay son, too.
West Hollywood. How are you?
Just great, Tom. Hey, we're sad to see you.
He's repping the 90069.
Absolutely, just like Dino.
And the evil person with that evil sense of humor that put that zip code in that area.
Yeah, isn't that something? We love it, though. Anyway, Tom, we're going to miss you. But I just wanted to say that I started listening to you when you first came on the air here in 1997. Your show started here on 97.1.
Yes.
And I've been with you ever since. And a lot of my gay friends listen to you faithfully. And were with you at Mickey's when you had that party down there years ago. Remember that?
We had Erasure on the show, as a matter of fact.
Yes, you did. Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Great show.
Thank you.
And we're just going to miss you, but we're going to look for you somewhere else when you decide to come back on the radio. And what can I say? Godspeed, as they say. And hey, I'd like to work at your ranch, too.
Hey, Jim, we'll set you up.
Yeah, well you got my number.
Sounds good to me. Thank you for that. By the way, I don't have his number. He had a blocked ID. 888-520-9710. It's Stephanie on the final edition of the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom. How's it going?
Oh, pretty well. You know, just sitting here watching my friends go to unemployment after today.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. But, you know, I just wanted to tell you that I think you're great. And, you know, I think all women should have listened to you if they hadn't. But, you know, I also want to make sure that all the women out there are out there with their headlights on. Ben, if you're listening, keep your headlights on, buddy. And Tom, can you take me out African tribe style?
African? Well, African tribe style would be something totally different. But African tribal style, yes. AAA 520-9710 is the telephone number. Jose on the Tom Likas Show, the final Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Goodbye, Tom.
Goodbye, Jose.
Big fan, Tom. I just want to wish you and the whole crew, Dino and Gary, best of luck, man.
Thank you so much.
I've been to a couple of your live events, a couple of Playboy matches, man, and you changed my life. I want to thank you.
I love that. Did you get lucky?
Oh, you better believe it.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Can you take me out? Can you take me out Brian Willis style / Frank Kramer style, please?
What would that be?
That would be a crying baby.
A crying baby? Yes,
And Latinos, you showed up.
Oh, yes. I give you both of those. Here you go.
Uh.
1-800-5800-TOM. No, it's not. It's 888-520-9710. That's the telephone number here. Let's say hello here to Nelson. Nelson is calling from Upland on the final Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Nelson.
No! I gotta tell you, when I heard the news, I actually called my sister because my sister never cared much for you, but I've like been a huge fan. And I said, I talked to her and I said, I'm really, really upset right now. And she goes, what's the matter? She thought there was something wrong. And I said, Tom Likas has gone off the air. And if it's any consolation, she was actually this up too. She was like a closeted listener. So I just want to thank you for your advice. Your advice is up to the teeth. It's funny how people always never wanted to hear and said, oh, this guy's full of this and the other or whatever. And then they would call later saying, Tom, you were right. I knew you were right all along. And for whatever it's worth, gay, straight, whatever lifestyle, you were always, you know, right. Guys want what they want. And this is that's just the bottom line. And you're the only one who actually had the guts to say, this is how it is. Deal with it. So thank you. Good luck. I'm not going to say God bless because I know you're going to curse me out for that. And take me out African tribal style, and I hope to see more of you.
All right. Here you go.
Tom, 1-800-5800-TOM. Tom. 1-800-5800-866. The Tom Likas Show.
The final edition of the Tom Likas Show, 888-520-9710. And in 15 minutes, we're going to put this place away into our memory banks. Thank you so much for supporting us all these years. And while I'm being serious for a second, because, you know, we do all the sniping, whatever, on the air, but my sincere thanks to my partners in this broadcast, Gary Sobranski, our producer, and Dean D'Amelio, our screener. They have done a spectacular job. You could not have two better friends in the whole world. Coming in and seeing them every day and working with them is what I will miss the most of everything about coming to work. That was the absolute best. And Gary and I have been together for 12 years. 12 years. Amazed. I've never been with anybody 12 years. No offense, Eric Braverman, but never worked with anybody for 12 years. That's because Eric moved on. But it was a fantastic run for all of us. And we had the most fun working together. Sure, we complained, but we had the most fun. Do you guys have any parting shots you want to take here before I take another phone call?
Yeah, I'm actually looking forward to Monday. You know how they did Day Without a Mexican and yeah. They did Day Without Monday is Day Without Dino, and it's going to be just fantastic.
Day Without an Italian.
For like 10 years, I've had to see this guy every day. Absolutely awesome, awesome run. The gig of a lifetime. We killed it. It was, I don't think people would believe it if we told them all the things that we've done over the last 12 years.
Well, most importantly, I think a lot of people think that this is like the Frosty, Heidi, and Frank show where we make stuff up and it's hyperbole.
Right.
That we really did the stuff we said we did.
traveled the world, best hotels, finest restaurants, the greatest wine, and we partied hard during the whole damn thing.
Yes.
It was fantastic. I heard a lot of people crying on the air today. No chance, man. This was the greatest experience. I'm grateful, thankful to have had the opportunity. And I woke up this morning happy. I went to bed last night happy. Woke up this morning happy. It really was the greatest gig, gig of a lifetime for sure.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And Dean, do you have any final comments here?
Well, thank you for the education, and that's an understatement. I really started off, as you say, as the original hanger-on and managed to parlay it into a career. And what I've seen with my own eyes, I absolutely never thought possible. I mean, there's debauchery that you're unable to even say on the air, and that's no joke. It's been the best experience of my life. I really owe you for where I am today and where I'll be tomorrow. And
which is unemployed.
That's true.
You might want to check out your exit package there.
I'll be down at the EDS office. Anyway, I owe you everything, and your fans are some of the most loyal people in the world. I mean, the outpouring of love for us just in the email alone over the past 2 days has just been just phenomenal. I mean, they are the best fans on earth, period.
Yeah, and they are the most loyal fans that you could want to have. And look, everyone's giving us a toast in the other room there. Thank you so much, guys. All the other folks at the radio station, Jack Silver, in absentia, Bob Moore, of course, and all the folks who made our life here fantastic. So great to have Johnny Kay from K-Earth 101 and my friend Eric Braverman in here, and everybody else who's worked with us over the years, Ron Steffen, Scott Ramsey. I mean, I could have a list a mile long of people, and they had to see it to believe it. It was just an amazing, amazing situation for such a long time. And that's why I can't walk out of here being sad or bitter. Many people have said to me, hey, come on, did you want to take some shots on the way out the door? At what? And having 12 amazing years like this? Are you kidding me? It's been absolutely the greatest run we could possibly have had. We will resurface when the time is appropriate, and you will stay with us at MySpace. And, or of course, you go to MySpace.com/TomLikas, and where you go to BlowMeUpTom.com. And wherever I go, or if I make a TV appearance or two, or if there's a pilot in the works or a book deal or whatever's happening, I'll let you know what's happening. I'll take some pictures of the ranch so that you and Frank Kramer can see what you're missing. And it's all going to be a lot of fun. But my thanks to everybody who made our life so great. And no matter how much we complained over the years, come on. Come on. how do you complain about this? It's fantastic. All right, we're going to take as many as we can, and then we're going to take this radio station out in style, as I have promised you. I also promised the management in writing, and I notarized it, so I have to do it. But let's say hello here to David, who's listening to us online in Ohio on the final Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, father.
Hello, son.
Tom, I've been listening to you for 11 years, man. You've got me exactly where I am in life. No wife, no kids. I'm working on an MBA. I've got 2 bachelor's degrees. I couldn't be more proud of you, sir. I mean, I don't know what else to tell you. I look up to you, everything that you do. Gary, Dino, you guys are the best. I'm not going to miss you because you're going to be back. So that's the way I look at it.
Well, thank you so much for that, and I appreciate that call. Let's say hi here to Ken on the final Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello.
And I'm sorry to interrupt you, Aunt, because I know we got to go fast. But on behalf of myself and all of your many, many fans that have been listening to you for years, thank you so much for everything that you've done for all the boys and the women, teaching them how men think, and everything that you've done. You've been great. And I know that you guys will end up back on your feet at another radio station doing the same gig or something similar. I just have one question for you, though, Tom.
Yes.
They give you some kind of a, in your contract or whatever they did at the end, did they have like a no compete clause or anything where stay off the air? Like,
well, I'm an employee here, and I continue to be an employee here. I'm just going to be sitting on the bench. It's like if you signed a contract to play for the Lakers. Like, let's say you were the second white guy on the Lakers.
Right. You're not playing much.
Like that guy they just got for the Charlotte Bobcats who never gets to play. Now, the guy's got a contract.
Right.
So, Phil Jackson never puts him in the game. It's kind of like that. He can't say, well, since I'm not playing, Phil, I'm going to go play for the Clippers.
Right. So you have to be quiet for a while then.
Well, I'm not going to be quiet. I'm just not going to be speaking into a microphone that has a transmitter attached to it.
Right. I understand. Okay. For how long, though?
Until the appropriate time. And you have to stay in tune with MySpace and our website, and then you'll know.
Okay, well, I'll do that, and I hope all your other listeners will, too, and we'll stay.
Sign up as my friend on MySpace, and I will just deluge you with unwanted messages and various communiques.
Tom, I appreciate it. I've been listening to you for years. There's only one way to take me out, because I've been around for so long, and I think you know what that is.
What is that?
Blow me up.
Of course. 1-800-5800-TOM. We're coming down to the last phone call here. Let's say hello here to Rachel. Let's get Rachel in here. Rachel, you're on the final Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Rachel.
I'm really going to miss you.
We're going to miss you too, darling.
Oh, where are you going?
Well, I'm not going anywhere. The radio station is changing format.
I don't believe it.
I live right here in the Hollywood Hills, and I will continue to live here.
Uh-huh.
And I will continue to make appearances on TV and do various things, and you'll see my name around. And at some point, I'll be back on the radio at the appropriate time.
Wow. I couldn't believe it. I heard it on the radio yesterday. I had to find out where you were going.
Well, I'm not going anywhere. In fact, at 5 o'clock, the station's going to change format. And I'm still going to be sitting here in the studio.
Well, I hope my drive home from work isn't going to be dull. You make it exciting for me.
Well, you could try masturbation.
Tom.
Whatever you have to do.
Well, whatever I have to do to get excited.
Whatever floats your boat, darling.
Okay, well, take me out. Can you kind of do a twist? Do me Bong Hit and Lacey Peterson.
All right, let's see if we can pull that off.
Emmer. Hey. Emmer. Emmer, make you a few
friends. All right. There they go. Now, I fished around. People said, what are you going to do? What are you going to do for the end of the show? How are you going to end it? And I tossed and turned. And I've known since last summer this was a possibility that this format was going to change. Let's tell the truth. I knew it was possible. And I thought about it. And I thought, what could I say that would wrap this all up? And then I one day heard this song. And I realized the lyrics of this song are about me.
Pretty soon now, you know I'm gonna make a comeback. And like goodbye melodies in the trees and the show fast smash. I'll speak to the masses of the media. Cash, so baby, you should get around time.
Thank you, Gary. Thank you, Dino. Thank you, Jack Silver. Thank you, Bob Moore. Thank you, all my friends here in the studio, for being here. And thank you to everybody in Southern California who's made this 12 great years. Let's do this thing one more time.
KLSX-FM in HD Los Angeles.
Welcome to the new E71 Amp Radio. All the hits.